Is Swift worth learning?
Not so fast there. Which version of Swift do you want to learn?
The one Apple says the next version of the iOS and OS X will be written in. Swift is what Apple says they want to work in.
Unfortunately, Swift itself is still a work in progress.
It is a new programming language. I know there are not a lot of resources to learn about it yet, but those who do know it will have the most opportunities.
Swift has had quite a few changes to it in beta, and it still has more changes to be made. The developers are planning to make changes to its syntax, and host of other changes
that could break any practice code I may have written.
And it ruins any habits and patterns you've gotten into.
That also ruins any code in the repositories that are written in Swift.
That's not an issue yet, because there is not any yet. Swift is still Apple's domain.
So is Objective-C.
Objective-C is what all of the on-the-shelf iOS devices run, and that's what all the third-party libraries are written in.
So if I want a job, I have to use Objective-C.
More importantly, it will take a year or more before Swift has a solid, final form ready for people to start coding in.
Apple wants to develop the iOS 8 in Swift and the Yosemite OS X.
They can do it in Objective-C if Swift is not ready in time. And no matter how fast the Swift rollout, the fact that their programmers do not all know it means Objective-C will still be used for a long time.
Does that mean I should not learn Swift?
If you're new to programming for Apple, learn Objective-C. That's what will get you a job today, and for a long time in the future.
It looks like everything in the future requires knowledge of both, if only to convert Objective-C applications to Swift.
Just wait until Swift has a final version out before you learn it, so you are not obsolete when they issue the final initial version of the language.
And it will be easier when they have Swift for Dummies, Idiots, and Loons.
I've never heard of the Loons series.
They've already got a blog or book for every other type of not-so-fast would-be programmer.
You'll have to learn Swift eventually to work with the Apple product line, but do not rush out to learn it.
But if I'm too slow, I'll be obsolete by the time I learn Objective-C.
NASA still has programs in Lisp and Haskell.
And the missile control system still uses floppy drives, but that does not mean I need to know anything about it, except that there is similar technology in the museum today. So when Swift matures, then I have to learn it.
At least wait long enough to find out if Swift actually takes off and does not end up like Google's Go and Dart languages that stalled and missed the mark, respectively.